Yo, what's going on, guys?
What's up, y'all?
What's going on, guys?
Have you heard?
It's Zac Greer. This is baby. I'm getting too fucked up for way too long. I should probably pay these girls I get hung up on because they write my songs. Maybe God can save me.
What's up, y'all? We're Have You Heard Music here with Zac Greer. I'm Joel.
The DTO.
And today we're going to be reviewing some fast food with the boy Zac after his excellent performance at Overcast and Friends show here in Philadelphia. So we got some Dunkin' Donuts. What you got over there, Zac?
I have an egg McMuffin.
What do you got?
I got a sourdough bacon, egg, and cheese.
Okay, I got some avocado toast.
How you feeling these days, Zac? How you feeling about the show yesterday?
Really, really fucking good.
Yeah.
I don't know, it was just something else, man. And then right after my set, I just jumped in the crowd and raved to the rest of the sets. It was really cool, man. My whole fucking body hurts.
Wait, with your set, like, we'll throw a picture up there, but you had, like, the disco ball and, like, the curtains and the suit. Like, that seems to be the whole, like, creative direction for the EP. Like, where does that come from?
I don't know, man.
Because, like, it's very, like, the branding is done right for the EP, right? Like, you're always wearing the suit and, like...
Yeah, I kind of feel like I'm playing a character in this EP. Not even, like, playing a character that's not me, but just kind of, like, romanticizing the story a little bit. And, like, Igor, you know, how he's, like, telling a story and he's the character, but it's, like, also a different version of him.
Yeah.
The story of the EP is kind of, like, it almost... The songs in order tell the story of like a relationship and just like the different stages of it. This whole aesthetic of like a like young love, like high school dance at prom alone, shit like that was really cool.
Resonates with the
youth. Yeah, totally. Yeah. But you don't even have to like put that on paper for somebody to see like a suit under a disco ball and kind of get the vibe of it a little bit.
Yeah.
I think I'm ready to give... Sorry, I don't want to interrupt you.
No, you're good.
I might be ready to give my Egg McMuffin a rating.
Yeah, how are you feeling?
Let me take one more bite. It's really good, man.
Yeah, my sourdough sandwich, I'd give it a solid, like, 8. Could have used some more bacon, but it was very... I feel very, sustained. Is that the right word? I feel very like
satisfied
and full. Like it didn't make me feel like garbage. Like some fast food breakfasts make me feel. It makes me feel like I'm ready for the day.
I'll update on how I feel because I don't know if this is gonna make me feel like garbage or not. But it's actually like very good. I think without the nostalgia factor of like the Egg McMuffin, because this is my first time having like one of these, I would probably like this a lot more. And if I kept eating this, I probably would too. I'm gonna give it a 7.5.
Alright. It's very respectable. Yeah.
Nice.
What about you, Aditya?
I got an avocado toast.
Oh shit. Did you?
Yeah. It was like, okay, it was pretty gas, like, but you can definitely tell it's like a little bit pasty. You know?
Ooh.
But I think the bar for avocado toast is just so high. But I have to give it like a solid like 5 out of 10, I think. Not bad at all for a little fast food joint, but
yeah.
Yeah, out in LA. One avocado toast. Like.
Okay. Oh, yeah. It's not as bad as LA.
Firstborn child.
Yeah, actually, I'm going to increase the rating to like a 6.5 because this was $2.
Really?
So, yeah, it was $2.29.
$2?
Yeah, wow. So, I mean, for that price, like, you could literally get 14
lower for, like, expectations.
LA, like one LA avocado toast.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
There you go.
Keep expectations low so you can surpass them.
Yeah.
Boom.
All right.
Content.
Let's go.
Don't know what to say, where'd it go wrong, how to get this weight somehow. Girl, we should turn the lights out. Yeah. Spent a couple months, took our best shot, but it wasn't love, strikeout.
All right, we're at the next stop, Popeyes. I've never been to Popeyes.
Really?
But yeah. Wait, so I'm vegetarian, so I'll be rating all the veggie options for our
I'm down with that, actually, because I'm not down for some chicken right now.
Should I get the coleslaw? I'm going to get coleslaw, because I don't like coleslaw.
Step out of your comfort zone.
Yeah. That's what it's about, man.
Baby, I just want you.
Popeyes.
We're hitting the fries.
We ate way too much Dunkin' Donuts.
Yeah, that we did.
This fries looks fucking...
ordered three tenders, but they gave me like five.
There's about four fries in there.
This shit looks good, though. It is some killer fries.
Yeah.
You know what? Let's try this. I don't love the Popeyes fries.
Damn.
They got that Cajun seasoning, though. Mm-hmm.
I like my fries to be just that.
Yeah, I also give this Popeyes a 8 out of 10. I mean, I know what I got into coming to this Popeyes.
Yeah.
And they did not disappoint.
I need to try my coleslaw. Oh, wow.
Hmm.
It doesn't look great. It's too white. You see, like, it doesn't even pick it up because it's
a little bit off-white.
It's off-white.
It's a little bit off-white, no Virgil.
Coleslaw.
First off, how's that coleslaw, though?
I'm going to give that coleslaw. If you like coleslaw, maybe it's like a 5. I don't like coleslaw, and it's also underperformed. I'm going to go with a 2.
Wow. True enough.
There's a song that I made on the EP called Sunday that I made with this guy right here.
That was a crazy session.
Who did the guitar. Intense beat, baby, tell me, can we turn Sunday into Monday? And the next week, wouldn't that do? In that song, we started at like 11 p.m.
Yeah,
like
we midnight. Pulled up to Chase's place. I was just there to hang out and play Super Smash Bros.
Just accidentally made a song.
Zach is pretty bad, so, you know, he was tired of losing.
He kicked my ass.
So we were like, all right, I guess since this is not really fun anymore, let's hop in the studio, try making a song. And
yeah, then Joel just started playing this fucking
little
guitar
riff.
Loop, and yeah. I just wrote the hook over it in like 15 minutes, and then we all looked at each other and we're like, all right,
yo,
we're
this is kind of crazy. Yeah,
this is what he played.
I think you FaceTimed me that night, like, yeah. You know, or like the next day.
One way down a one way on 10 speed, baby, tell me, can we turn Sunday into Monday, and the next week, wouldn't that do?
But we started that at like midnight.
Yeah, that was one of my craziest music experiences ever. Like, I really was not planning to make any music that night. Mm. And then we were just like,
we wrapped it at 6 in the morning.
Yeah,
we
started that at like 11 or midnight, and then he made that hook, the wrong way, and then I was from there. We just all looked at each other and was like, yo, yeah, like, this
fuck.
Is kind of crazy. We might just have to sit down and just write an entire song around that hook because it was so catchy.
Yeah, toward like 3 or 4 in the morning when I was writing the second verse, the beat was just playing and they were just like sitting on their phones, and I was like,
I was
fading out in and out of consciousness. And, but then I wrote it, and then we were good, and Joel got to leave.
Yeah, the energy was great. I remember I left, and it was light outside.
Yeah, I left.
I got there, it was light outside, and then I left, and it was light outside.
Yeah.
I felt so... It was just such a...
Really cool, but also... Wow.
Yeah.
One way, down a one way, on the 10 speed. Baby, tell me, can we turn Sunday into Monday? In the next week, wouldn't that 3, 4? One way, down a one way, on the 10 speed. Baby, tell me, can we turn Sunday?
Alright, our last stop. We got some Frosties from Wendy's.
I'm so fucking full.
Zach, tell me about our good friend PNW Eli.
Everybody thinks I faked that shit, man. That's so funny.
That's really absurd, dude. I've never heard of anything like that.
No, nobody has. And I get
hella.
Why it looks fake. No, it didn't stream hella.
It just linked, had the same
it
ISRC.
Linked to my...
Oh. I thought it had, like, its own Millie, like, on its own.
Had my Millie.
Oh, okay.
But it looked like he either juiced it or, like, posted it, and then it did really well off of his shit.
Did you ever reach out? Like, did you ever get any, like...
My manager... found his mom.
His Spotify bio as well is like,
oh, that was hilarious.
What was the bio?
Like, PNW Eli has been writing for a long time.
I'm gonna find it in my story archive. And from a young age, born and raised, his name in the small town of Post Falls, Idaho, period, knew he was different. Period. And he was around the age of 7, he quickly started learning to rap songs from the likes of Flo Rida to AC/DC.
Yeah, bro needs to stay in school and learn some punctuation.
His mother encouraged him to release his music, saying it's amazing and one of a kind. So one night at 4
One of a kind, baby.
Yo, come on. So one night at 4 a.m. on a Christmas Eve night, period. After dealing with a breakup, period. Elijah wrote Melatonin.
Did he like try to refute it when you called him out on it?
Or did he just
eat the L and just...
Well, he's like a ghost on social media. Like, even before the shit happened, he didn't have an Instagram. Like, nothing except for a TikTok with one post on it. And then when I posted the video, everybody found his TikTok and just, like, shit on him.
Yeah. TikTok is a ruthless place. How do you feel about TikTok as an artist?
Oh, I hate it. It's good because you can more than ever make it without having connections or whatever. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You don't need anything to make it except for a viral video.
Yeah.
On the other side of shit, if you do make it with viral video, then you're expected to keep making viral videos and kind of that be your whole brand as an artist.
Yeah.
And then it makes it harder if you're on the other side of shit where you don't want to be posting on TikTok. It's almost harder because people are almost exclusively going to TikTok to look for new shit.
Yeah.
So you're almost forced to at least represent yourself a certain amount. I like watching TikToks.
Yeah. Yeah. You and me have similar For You page tastes.
Yeah. Yeah.
I can relate on the dumb content that we get fed.
And then I remember that I have to post them.
You can't choose what you see, but I'm also not mad because they put fire stuff in my feed.
Yeah, no, it's great. As a social media app, it's phenomenal.
It's pretty entertaining.
I love it.
But as a platform.
As me being an artist, it's a little draining.
This shit was fire.
You want some of the frost?
Let me get some.
Dude, I made like this much of a dent though.
Yeah.
But it is very good.
I'll give it a 10 out of 10 for myself at least.
Frosty's never missed. 10 out of 10.
All right. That ends the food portion of our trip or our video, but we are in Philly and Zach's favorite movie or one of his favorite movies is Rocky.
One of my favorite movies is Rocky.
So enjoy this cute montage of us going and taking Zach to the Rocky steps.
Exploring the streets of Philly.
Actually, not your